video, I wanted to show you guys how I achieved this 10-minute makeup look. Now in this video, since I'm explaining all the steps, it takes longer to show you guys how I achieved this look, but when I'm, you know, on the regular putting on this makeup look, it takes me less than 10 minutes. So I've used very minimal products. This is my makeup routine that I go for, like when I'm in a rush, like if I just want to run out the door and, you know, run errands, but I want like a full face of makeup and I also want it to look natural. It's also very work appropriate. You can also wear it to work and places where you can't, you know, pile on too much makeup. There's no concealer, no bronzer, no contour, nothing of that sort. It's just really simple. I think there's just 5 products. So if you guys want to know how I got this look, please keep watching. So I'm gonna start off by prepping my face with the Bio Oil face oil. Now this oil really works well for me because, as you all know by now, I have really dry skin. So I'll just take a couple of drops in the palm of my hand and I'll just massage it in. I always prep my face with a face oil because that helps, you know, the foundation go on much smoother. I'm having a lot of breakouts recently. I think it's hormonal because I usually never get any breakouts. Must be the stress and the change of weather and everything. So I'm gonna go in with my LA Girl Pro Coverage Illuminating Foundation. This foundation is my ride or die foundation. I don't think I've found a foundation that works better for me than this one. So as you all know, I'll just take a fluffy foundation brush like this and take one full pump of the foundation and just apply it onto my face. So I start with the center point of my face where I need the most coverage and I'll work my way out. Make sure you don't apply too much pressure on your face, just lightly buff it in. Now I'm just gonna build a little bit more coverage in areas that I need a little bit of coverage. So I'll just take a little more of the foundation and apply it to those areas. I have a little bit of hyperpigmentation here. So I'll just gently stipple the foundation onto that area. Now I'm not going to be using concealer or contour in today's video. So instead of that, I'm just going to add a little bit of dimension to my face by baking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use translucent powder. Now this is the RCMA No Color Powder. So I'm just going to take it on my wet sponge, like so, and apply it to all the highlight zones of my face. Now what this does is it'll give you a little bit of dimension. I'm also going to reverse contour, which means I'll add powder just beneath the contour area. I use this technique when I don't have enough time to like highlight and contour and conceal. So I'll just take the translucent powder and apply it right beneath where my natural contour would be. I'm not going to leave it on for too long because I have dry skin, and the longer you leave the powder on your face, it's just going to dry out your skin more. So I'll just take a fluffy brush like this one. This is by Real Techniques. Actually, most of my brushes are by Real Techniques. I mean, the quality is like amazing and the price point is also great. So what I'll do is I'll just lightly fluff off the powder. Now that's done, we can move on to blush. Now the blush is gonna be the highlight of this makeup look. Highlight in the sense, not the literal highlight, as in it's gonna be the main thing in the makeup look. So I'm just gonna go for a blush palette like this. Yeah, so this is by Makeup Revolution. It's their Ultra Blush palette in the variant Sugar and Spice. So you have like a nice range of blushes here. You have a coral blush, then a couple of pink blushes and two neutral blushes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick up this coral blush. So I'm gonna pick it up on this blush brush Now this brush, it comes in a set that I found on Amazon. I'll link it down below in the description box. So I'll just pick it up like so, tap off the excess, and when I apply the blush, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start off with the apples of my cheeks, and I'm just gonna work in a circular motion which covers, you know, my lid space all throughout. So like so, just close your eyes, and while you're doing this you should feel the brush grazing your eyelashes. That's how you know you're doing it right. So just gently apply the blush like so. You might have to build it up. I'm sorry, my chair is squeaking. Sounds really funny. So this makeup technique, it's an Asian makeup technique. I think it's Japanese. So as you all know, Asian makeup techniques like Japanese and Korean and stuff like that, they focus mainly on like natural makeup looks. This actually gives you like a very natural wash of color on your face. It looks like you're naturally blushing. It doesn't look like you've actually applied any blush. So what happens is there's this cohesiveness to your cheeks and your lid space, which looks beautiful. So you can build up the blush as much as you like. Once you're done applying the blush, just pull it back onto your temples, ever so slightly. On camera, it might look like I have clown cheeks, but I swear to God, blush is the first thing that tends to fade on your face. So even if you go in with a heavy hand initially, it'll fade like over a period of time, say over like 1 hour or so. So you don't have to worry about that. And besides, we're not applying any other products like bronzer or contour. It's just the blush. So now that's done, the next thing that I like to do is I like to apply this really fine highlighter onto the apples of my cheeks. Not the regular highlighter that you find in the market which has glitter particles. This is like extremely fine. I would compare this product to Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. It just gives you that natural glow. So the product that I found is very similar to that in texture is this highlighter in the Golden Sugar 2 Rose Gold palette. This is also an ultra blush palette by Makeup Revolution. So there's this highlighter over here, this one right here. It's very, very finely milled. You don't have any large glitter particles inside. It's just really finely milled. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick it up on the same blush brush. The excess, and I'm just gonna top my blush with this product. Now what this does is it gives you that really pretty ethereal glow. It looks very natural. It looks like your skin is like just glowing from within. So just apply that product like how you applied the blush. Nicely blend it in. Now that that's done, I'm gonna set my face with the L'Oreal Infallible Makeup Extender Setting Spray. You can also use MAC Fix Plus. I can't really find my bottle here, so I'm just gonna use this one. Now, if you're not happy with this natural highlight that's going on, you can always top it up with your traditional highlighter. So I'm gonna go in with that same palette, the Ultra Blush palette in Golden Sugar 2. Yeah, so the product we used initially was this one, which is really finely milled, whereas this one is a little more intense. So I'm just gonna pick this up on a highlighter brush. Actually no, I want to pick it up on a more precise brush. So there's this fluffy brush like this one, because I don't want to apply it like everywhere. I just want to apply it onto the high points. So I'll just target this area and the arch of my brow. I have a small blemish here, so I'm not gonna apply the highlighter over there. I'm just gonna apply it here. Because when you apply shimmery products, you know, over blemishes and acne, it's just gonna draw more attention to that. So I'm not gonna apply it there. Just apply it here. The tip of my nose, cupid's bow, chin, and the bridge of my nose. So for the eyes, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna use one cream blush. Because when we applied the blush onto our face, we managed to get a little bit of blush, you know, in the transition area. So you just need to add a little bit of cream eyeshadow. This is by Revlon and it's in the shade Praline. It's like this rose gold cream eyeshadow. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pick it up on the same brush that we used to apply the highlighter, which is this one. Because I don't want like an intense application, I just want like a fine wash of shimmer on the eyelids. And I'm just gonna apply it onto the inner one third of my eyelid. I don't want too much shimmer on the outer corner. Just apply it onto the inner one third of my eyelid. Okay, now we can curl our lashes and apply mascara. For mascara, I'm gonna be using the Falsies Push Up Drama Mascara by Maybelline. So what I do is I just take it to the root of my lashes and I'll wiggle it out. I make sure that I apply the most product onto the root of my lashes. Like even if the tips don't have that much product, that's okay, but you need to saturate the roots. That's how you make your lashes look much fuller. Don't forget to apply mascara on your lower lashes as well. Okay, now that we are done with the eyes, we can move on to the brows. Now for the brows, I'm not gonna apply any eyebrow powder or anything to fill in the gaps of my brows. I want it to look natural. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna take whatever excess is on the mascara wand. Like I'm not gonna dip it again. Whatever excess is there on the wand, I'm just gonna use that and I'm gonna brush my brow hairs into place. Now what this does is, it actually gives you that feathered look, which is like so much in trend right now. So I'll just brush out my brow hairs. This style of brow complements this kind of makeup looks really well because, you know, it enhances that natural thing that you have going on. Like if you have like a natural look like this and if you have like blocked brows, it's not gonna look really nice. You can also use a brow gel, but since I don't have a brow gel, I'm just gonna use my mascara. And please, if you're gonna do this, do it with waterproof mascara, because if you use regular washable mascara, it's not gonna give you any hold. Like after some time, your brow hairs are just gonna come down, which is not a very nice look. The whole point is you need to hold your brow hairs in place. Now, I haven't trimmed or done my brows in a long time, which is why it looks really wild. And that actually kind of looks nice when you have this style of brow going on. So if you haven't had time to thread your brows or wax your brows or trim them, just run a mascara wand through it and you're done. If you feel like there is any excess product on the mascara, just rub it off on a tissue and go back into your brows. You don't have to be too precise with this. This is actually an advantage as well, because when you are filling out your brows with a regular brow powder, you need to be extremely cautious of whether it's even on both sides. It's just kind of stressful, whereas this you can just go with the flow. Just go with how your brows naturally grow. Like whenever your mascara is dry out, you can actually use them for your brows rather than throwing it out. I just want to add a little bit of accent lashes to the outer corners of my eyes, you know, so that the look is a little more complete on camera. So I'll be right back. Okay guys, I've applied the lashes onto my eyes. Now what I mean by accent lashes is, I'm not gonna apply like an entire lash onto my eyes. I'm just gonna apply them onto the outer corners. What I do is I'll just take a pair of lashes and I'll cut out the inner corners of the lashes and I'll just apply the outer parts onto, you know, the outer part of my eyes. It actually gives you a more natural look. And also it's much more comfortable, because one of the biggest pet peeves of mine when it comes to lashes is when it, you know, starts irritating the inner corners of your eyes and you know your eyes start getting watery. So that's like really annoying. So my favorite thing to do at the moment is to apply accent lashes. So these lashes are just lashes that I found on Amazon.com. They're like super cheap. It's just like $250 or something, like for 10 pairs of lashes. I'll link it down in the description box below. Everything is done. Now all that is remaining are the lips. Now my favorite lip combo at the moment is a combo of these two lipsticks. As you can see, it's like a rosy, nudie brown lipstick. Yeah. So this is relatively darker and this is like lighter. This lipstick on its own, it's like really light for me. It washes me out, so I can't really apply this on its own. But when I combine these two, it's like amazing. So this lipstick is by this brand called Prestige Cosmetics. It's an Italian brand, I believe. This is their matte lip tint in the shade Timeless. So this is like a rosy brown color. This isn't nude enough for me. This looks like, you know, a regular brown lipstick. So in order to make it a little more nude, I top it off with the ultra matte lipstick by Colourpop in the shade Monday. One of the biggest tips I can give you with liquid lipsticks is, you know, to make it last longer, scrape off all the excess product from the wand, because the thinner the layer of the lipstick that you apply, the longer it lasts. Because if you keep applying lots of layers of liquid lipstick, it just tends to crumble off. I'll just scrape off all the excess onto the neck of the lipstick tube and I'll just apply it onto my lips. As you can see on its own, this is a little bit dark to my preference. I want it to be a little lighter. So I'm just gonna top it off with this lipstick by Colourpop. So again, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna scrape off all the excess product. I'm just gonna apply it to the center part of my lips. If you want, you can blend it out with a brush, a lip brush, or you can just use your finger. Depending on if you're in the mood for it, you can also top it off with a gloss, any clear gloss. So it depends on my mood. Some days I feel like going in with a matte lip, because that looks much neater and much more, you know, clean cut. As opposed to gloss, it makes it look a little more sexy, I feel. So that's it, guys. This is the full makeup look. So I hope you guys like this video. Now, if you guys like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, click on the bell notification button so that you get notifications when I post new videos. Thank you so much for watching. So until I see you the next time, always remember, fair isn't the only lovely.